Geometry-Dash is and has always been about pushing the limits of how skilled one can become in the rhythm-based platformer game genre. Ever since the game was released, players have actively been searching for ways to increase their skills and capabilities in order to become the greatest of all time. Proving their strong determination, they started making difficult levels that over time became even more and more difficult. Today, Geometry-Dash's difficulty skill standards are estimated to increase by almost 50% with every single passing year. There are levels so difficult that they take hundreds of thousands of attempts and hundreds of hours poured into them to only be completed once. And that poses a question: how far have players actually pushed the standards up until now? What is the true hardest level in this game that's ever been created and is set to one day be completed? Well, to answer that, we need to take a look at the Geometry-Dash level difficulty pyramid. By starting at the bottom, where every level begins, we have to work our way further towards the top and narrowing the amount of levels with each layer of the structure. So, let's look at the first stage. There, we have 7 basic Geometry-Dash level difficulties: Auto, Easy, Normal, Hard, Harder, Insane, and Demon. Logically, it would make sense that the hardest level bears the highest difficulty, meaning the demon rating, so let's examine that one more thoroughly. The demon rating was introduced with the custom levels update when a level called Demon Park was released. The creator of the game thought it was simply too hard to belong any of the 6 predecessing categories, so deriving from its name, the demon difficulty was introduced. Today, there are over 4,500 demon levels existing in the game, and only one person has ever managed to reach the 4,000 demon level completions mark, which is an achievement more insane than any of us can imagine. The demon rating has a very vast span, fluctuating from very easy demons to nearly impossible levels. So, in one of the past updates, the difficulty was split into 5 new separate sub-difficulties: Easy Demon, Medium Demon, Hard Demon, Insane Demon, and ultimately Extreme Demon, all of which represent the next layer of the difficulty pyramid. Again, if we were to look for the hardest level in the entire game, we would have to narrow our fields to the hardest sub-difficulty, the Extreme Demon. At the time of this video's release, there are about 400 Extreme Demons in the game today, meaning that nearly every 10th rated demon level is awarded the extreme rating. However, even after we only take extreme demons into consideration, and with that eliminate 90% of all demon levels and over 98% of all rated levels in the game, we still have a vast field to choose from. There are some extreme demons that nearly anybody could complete with some experience and practice, such as Thanatophobia, and on the other hand, there are levels that have one single purpose: to be the hardest humanly possible level ever created. A good example of such levels is an old creation called Tartarus. Tartarus was long ago an open level for anybody to try and complete, however, it took more than 2 years for somebody to actually manage to beat it. Currently, there are a total of 44 players that survived this one hell of a level afterwards. Tartarus was long thought to be the limit of this game's difficulty, but just the previous week of this script being written, things changed drastically. After a year and a half of being the most difficult rated level in all of Geometry-Dash, Tartarus was dethroned 3 times. Firstly, 2 levels, namely Firework and Slaughterhouse, which are both harder than Tartarus, were verified legitimately and rated, and later on, a level called Truefet, which was considered easier than Tartarus, has now officially been deemed more difficult. Out of the 3, Slaughterhouse is deemed the hardest, and currently sits at the first place of the most difficult rated level list. And so, we have our answer, but do we really? We browsed through every rated level in the game and found the hardest of them all, so what else could possibly be harder than that? Well, the truth is that the hardest levels aren't always eligible to receive a rate. Only levels that have a good enough decoration and gameplay are awarded stars, but when it comes to that, difficulty plays no role at all if the level is verified legitimately. With that in mind, let's take a dive into the unrated levels, which is the 3rd stage of the difficulty pyramid. There are vastly more unrated levels than there are rated ones, with over 60 million of them currently uploaded to the Geometry-Dash servers. Surely, there must be at least some that are harder than Slaughterhouse. And to think about it, there actually is a popular trend of difficult levels that do not meet the level rating criteria due to their length, the challenges. Challenges are levels too short to receive a rate, but their length doesn't reflect on their difficulty, as they are sometimes way harder than even extreme demons that are up to 10 times as long. Up until a month ago, the hardest challenge was a level called Delusion that was many times compared to some of the hardest extreme demons in the game. Just recently, however, another much harder challenge was verified legitimately that goes by the name of VSC. VSC is so insanely difficult considering considering its merely 16-second length that there are still discussions whether its verifier completed it legitimately or not. It is deemed harder than Tartarus and widely compared to even the newly thrown Slaughterhouse. In fairness, it's impossible to tell which one of them is harder, since right now, level difficulty cannot be efficiently measured yet. But then again, none of that actually matters, since there are levels much harder than VSC or Slaughterhouse. Those levels have existed for a long time with nobody completing them yet, that being the Impossible levels, the top layer of our level difficulty pyramid. Impossible levels are, as their name says, uncompletable by human capabilities, so they were completed by hacks or bot usage. Despite that, however, they still represent a big phenomenon within the Geometry Dash community, with some getting millions of views on YouTube. Popular Impossible levels can be divided into two separate categories, those that remain uncompletable, and those that are over the years recreated and made slightly more possible. An example of such levels is Silent Club, currently the 24th hardest level in the game. At the time of its creation, it was considered impossible, but as the difficulty standards skyrocketed over the years, it was actually completed legitimately and rated. That, however, doesn't apply to every single impossible level. Some of them are so difficult and require such precise timings that a human person couldn't possibly navigate through them. Since Silent Club was one of the first impossible levels in the game, many of those levels bear the name Silent, which has been designated as a reference to the word impossible. Examples include Silent Clubstep, Silent Circles, Silent Locked, and many more. Another case of impossible levels slowly becoming possible is Sakupan Circles, a level from over 6 years ago that has been classified as uncompletable all this time, with significant progress being made on it recently. If this was to get legitimately completed and rated, it would definitely be considered the hardest level to ever get completed in the entire game. So, in the long run, what is the most difficult Geometry Dash level? Answers to that may vary, since there are dozens of different aspects as to what we look at when we ask ourselves that question. Among rated levels, that title belongs to Slaughterhouse. Among legitimately completed levels, there's a clash between Slaughterhouse and VSC. And among every level ever built, well, we might never know. But we do know for sure that the hardest Geometry Dash level is an impossible one, built to not be completed legitimately. We cannot know what the hardest impossible level is for two reasons. Difficulty cannot objectively be measured, and there are simply too many to keep track. One thing is clear, however. Over time, as impossible levels become possible, more and more of them will start to become viewed as completable, and when the community is able to beat levels like Silent Clubstep, even harder impossible levels will be created in response. That process is very reminiscent of the Hydra myth. For every head we manage to cut off, two of them will grow back in its place. It's a trend that's been going on for 7 long years since Geometry Dash players have been able to build their own levels, and it doesn't seem to be stopping due to the fact that impossible levels are now more popular than they have ever been. My name is Alias, and I would like to thank you for staying until the end of this video. A lot of time and effort went into the research, so if you wish to see more of such content in the future, you can support me by subscribing and helping me get closer to the 100,000 milestone. See you later.